All right, guys, I literally haven't started this thing in probably a month, maybe more. Let's see if it starts up. First try, haven't touched, like I said, I haven't touched this thing in over a month. And let's see if it fires up. There you have it. You can always rely on a Jay-Z to start. They're amazingly reliable. So anyway, but this is just a little update video. I know every video seems like it's just an update video, but I have so much work to do, and I just don't have time to, you know, make videos and go do car things. It is what it is, you know. I have stuff to do. I have to get this shop done. I've been putting up shelves here, making benches for my sandblast cabinet, another bench over here for a grinder and a vise, and just, yeah, it is what it is. I have to do these things. And over here, more shelves, and this is gonna be my welding little area right here. Got my, the MIG welder, and then the TIG welder down here, trying to pull it on, it's having a hard time. Yeah, and then this is a lot of all my car stuff. We have the 1J non-VVTi, which, oh yeah, that's the title of the video. That motor, I'm thinking of putting that motor in this Tacoma here. Let's check this out. Okay, so that's a 1998 Tacoma with a little extra cab in it. I found that on Facebook, obviously, for three grand, and I just really like it. And not to mention, I hit a deer with my F-150, and the fender's all messed up, and I need to get that fixed. And there's something else wrong with it too. It's idling funny. So I've always wanted a Tacoma, and where I live right now is pretty far from my shop. So it cost me quite a bit to drive the F-150, you know, that whole way. It's a little over an hour, right around an hour. And the Tacoma should get me a lot better gas mileage, and won't cost me $25 to drive over here. So that's another one of the reasons I got it. And obviously Tacomas are really reliable, and you know, I like the way they look. And so I'll put a picture up. It came with these weird rims. Off of like a Camry or something like that. And I went ahead and bought some of original Steelys, which I'm gonna try to make this truck look kind of like old school.
I'm gonna lower it a little bit, and what I did was I found these Steelys in a junkyard for $35 each, and I went ahead and just painted them like gloss black, and I bought some chrome trim rings that's gonna go around this, and I bought some new lug nuts, some nice chrome lug nuts, and this is gonna be lowered 2 inches. So there should be only about this much of a gap. So, and I'll have to lower the front too. So yeah, that's kind of the plan with this truck. And then the plan is to put that in the Tacoma. So I bought this, you know, I don't know a lot of people, like I got new subscribers, so there's probably a lot of that you don't know, but you know, this is a 1JZ Fox body, and about a year ago, I found this 1JZ non-VVTi on Facebook for like $500, and I couldn't pass it up because it had a good cylinder head, and the bottom end was locked up. And what it ended up being was a ring had stuck and kind of froze to the wall of the cylinder or something like that, and it was locked up. But the cylinder head was good. It needs a valve job, but the cylinder head was good. And you can't touch a 1J, 2J cylinder head for under $1,200, you know? So I figured for $500, I'm just buying the cylinder head. And not to mention, I sold a couple things off of it. I sold the rear sump pan, I've sold the crank, I sold a few things off of it, and I basically got it for free. So anyway, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna probably end up putting that in there. I may not mess around with trying to you know, find a crank and do a find a you know, pistons and all that. I may just buy another 1J, okay, and just use the bottom end on it. I can get a 1J for around $1,300-$1,400. And it would cost me a lot more in like machine work and buying pistons and all that and a crank. So if I just buy another 1J. Use the short block on it, because I really, really want, I mean, I could throw the whole thing in there. I could do that. But I really want to do a non-VVTi. Now, what the plan would probably be, would be to put the non-VVTi in the Mustang, and then put this motor that's in the Mustang in the truck. So that's kind of where I'm going with it, because I don't need the VVTi in the Mustang. It's not necessary, because when I'm drag racing it, I'm out of the operating range of the VVTi. So I'm leaving around 4,500 RPMs, and the VVTi works way below that. So once I'm up into the 4,500 RPM range, the VVTi is, I believe the cam goes back to zero, so it doesn't really matter. I believe that the cam gets retarded when you're at lower RPMs to give you more torque. Okay, so which is good for street driving. You know, that's a really good thing to have when you're driving on the street. So you can have more low end torque, you know, from a stoplight to a stoplight, you get more a low end out of it. Because this is just a 2.5 liter engine. So they had to kind of, that's what they came up with the VVTi for, is because of, to get the, you know, to get these things to make good power down low, they needed to have that, be able to advance and retard the cam. I'm not 100% sure the way it works, but I do know that it's either advancing or retarding, one of the two, to where it gives you more torque on the lower RPMs. Anyway, like I said, I don't need it with that. I don't need it with the with drag racing. It just doesn't, it's totally unnecessary. This is unnecessary. This VVTi solenoid's unnecessary. Me wiring it into the ECU and then programming it's unnecessary. It's just a lot of unnecessary stuff. So I have a couple options of what I could do. I can take this head off of that 1J, do the valve job and get that all, you know, get some new valve springs in it and all that. And oh, by the way, it has 2J cams in it. When I bought it, the guy had 2J cams machined to fit into a 1J. So it actually has upgraded cams. So yeah, let's come over here and look at this. So yeah, and I've also started to do some port work on it. okay, cleaning up the ports. I could take it off and show you, but and also the chambers too. And I also have I picked up this manifold for it. This is just a steel manifold. It's not stainless or anything like that. It's just it's a real heavy duty manifold. Picked it up off eBay. It's got a nice T4 flange on it. This wastegate here is probably nowhere near efficient enough of what we're gonna need. So this is gonna have to be changed. What I see a lot of people doing lately is putting the wastegate actually off of the exhaust housing. And that seems to help you control boost a lot better when it's right at the exhaust housing. You know, when your exhaust gas is having to make a U-turn right here, come down here, you'll get really bad boost creep. And this one already does that. Okay. I have, what do I have in there? I think I have 14 pound springs in it, and it goes up to 21 pounds of boost already. So I'm already, even this wastegate deal here is not sufficient. I don't know if you can see it or not, but it just U-turns and comes down and goes down to the bottom there. So you want your wastegate to be in the path of your exhaust. You don't want your wastegate tube to go and do a U-turn, because then it's gonna cause boost creep. Okay. So like I said, this one does do that. So anyway, that's the plan. And then what we'll do is we'll take this head, and I'll either find a short block, if somebody's selling a short block for $500-$600 or whatever, and I'll throw that head on that, and that can go in the Tacoma. So, and I also already have at home, my other house, an automatic transmission that I took off of this when I did the Turbo 400 swap. So I already have an automatic transmission. I just have a lot of things that I wouldn't have to buy. Okay. Another thing is I'm redoing the whole fuel system in this car. Okay. And I have a 250 LP fuel pump in this car, so I can take that fuel pump, put that in the Tacoma. So there you go. I have my upgraded fuel system on that, because this is getting the E85 system. You know, I have the pump over here, the Dishworks pump. I actually have just a lot of things that, you know, I have leftover stuff that I can use for that. Tons of intercooler piping over here that I have, couplers and V-bands, and I have a mass air meter for that. What else? Yeah, I have all kinds of stuff to make it work. So, and I actually think, I've been doing some research, and this manifold that I have on this 1J non-VVTi actually might be a little better than this CX Racing manifold. And the reason I say that is more for a spool, because I've done some research, and some of these manifolds that like CX Racing is making for these 1Js and 2Js, the manifolds are actually, the diameters are too big. Okay, and what that does is it kills spool. It kills velocity of the exhaust gases. Okay, so these are, I'm not 100% sure what the diameter is, but they're definitely bigger than these here, these runners. Definitely bigger. These are smaller runners. And this is a smaller opening and everything. So it'll be something fun to experiment with, because right now the spool on this is terrible. You can sit there and have a sandwich while it's trying to spool up. So we have to use nitrous to get it to spool up. I have to use nitrous in order to get it on the trans brake, and all that. So that manifold may be better. We don't know. So, but it'll be something cool to try. And yeah, so that's pretty much the update. Still working on my shop, and just have a lot of things to do. You know, I'm making this video, and I feel bad because it's not really like a fun video where I'm taking the car and doing rips on it or anything like that. But I have a bunch of new subscribers and I just kind of want to give everybody an update. So, but yeah, and I'm just kind of building shelves and built a shelf here, and I got these signs here. These are pretty cool. This one here may go up here. Maybe like this. Let's see if it'll sit there. Kind of like that. This for sales and service. Just some kind of unique stuff that I like. And then another one I may put maybe over there or something like that. I don't know. But I picked those up in North Carolina at a little vintage shop or something like that. But anyway, so yeah, that's gonna be the update for this video. My wife says I have too many projects, but I'm not sure what she's talking about. But anyway, I hope you guys like this video. Hope you like the update. Probably gonna be getting to the track soon, just because of the fact that I'm gonna get the fuel system going soon and then take it to the track, because we have Cletus and cars coming up. I believe it's in April, and I definitely want to go to that. He bought that new track down in DeSoto Speedway. That's pretty cool. We used to go there all the time when I was younger, and it's been closed for a few years, but I guess he bought it and is gonna fix it up and whatever, so that's cool. But hope you guys like this video. Like, share, subscribe. If you want to see some Tacoma things and Fox body things with Japanese motors that I get a lot of hate for, but it's all good. I don't really care. I get people messaging me or making comments about how this is total blasphemy to put a Japanese motor in a Mustang, but whatever. It doesn't really matter to me. I laugh at it. I think it's funny. But anyway, all right, guys, check out more videos, and you can subscribe over here, and I'll check y'all next time. See ya.